most of them for years.
This is 3 years ago. 3 years ago, you said?
No, it was last November, 1 year ago. Exactly.
Okay.
Does the public know about this?
Yeah.
Government?
Yeah, sure.
For them, trying to.
No, it's August, they are out now. Yeah. It's very difficult to, because there's a lot of political parties who are behind. You know, they are very organized too.
So they have to fight?
Yeah, what they do afterwards, 3,500 people, what they do with them.
Yeah. You know, from all over?
This is, for example, he's Turkish. He's probably maybe from Mali, maybe from Senegal. They were, at one moment, there were how many nations? 50 nations. From Bangladesh also.
And how? They were friendly with each
other? No, not automatically, but there were strict rules, very strict rules, security, people. She's a very active fighter. She's a very strong woman.
Where is she?
You can tell.
She's from Algeria. Yeah, but not too much, because finally they're all in the same fight.
This one's great.
So it was open spaces, you know. So conflict were solved very quickly too. It was a little bit like a structure, like in a combat, like you have in an army with very strict rules. You know, if you're not following, you're kicked out. You're out of it if you put the other ones into risk. Actually, the portraits were done in the center space of the occupation, an open space which was next to the train room, which was open too. And I just installed a light and like a little studio, but like really the center, people could see from all over. He's from Bangladesh. He explained to me that they're probably the first, escape from a natural, from climate change. It's not livable anymore. And this will continue. I mean, there will be more climatic reasons. He helped me a lot because he's an electrician, and sometimes when life broke down, he fixed it.
That's very nice.
That are from Kurdistan.
Did you stay with them? You said
6 months.
6 months. Yeah. You actually lived there in the space with them?
Not always, but a lot of times.
Yeah. And how did they get their food, the water, all that? How was it organized?
Yeah. It was organized. They were for help, like people helping. Giving money who were around, and so it was cooking. The women were cooking.
Well, good food, no?
Yeah, depending on how much they.
Well, I used to eat in the foyer. Yeah. Good food.
And but the funny thing is the dishes, yeah. It's men who are washing.
Okay.
It's not the women who wash the dishes, it's the men who wash the dishes.
Okay, that's good.
That's good.
You know, so it's done.
Little technical problem.
So, and a lot of Sunday girls, they were working, you know, they're working, they were sleeping, they had sometimes apartments somewhere, but they were sleeping also occupation. And going to work in the morning, when I woke up early in the morning, like 6 o'clock, I was in the light in the toilet with all the guys preparing themselves to work. They were mostly working in construction, cleaning. There was a big strike of the illegal immigrants in Paris who were working for the public, for the city, for the metro and everything. They went to strike, which was blocking all Paris. Because suddenly, they estimate 600,000 illegal workers in France.
Still today?
Yeah, yeah.
That's amazing.
600,000. There were even illegal immigrants striking in a restaurant where we were working. There were 23 in this restaurant, illegal, and this was a restaurant where they were closing on every day anymore.
Mm-hmm. And probably didn't know that.
He didn't know that. So it just showed in how many domains illegal immigrants are working for money, which they are totally underpaid, no security. I got to know people who blessed themselves as they went with a broken whatever toe to the work, because otherwise they would lose the job. They couldn't go to
a doctor because they had no social security then.
Yeah, sometimes they get kicked out without being paid, you know, so they work for nothing. They made a film. This was also making a lot of media when they worked for the metro, for the public transport system, renovating a station, and they showed the conditions. They worked with no mask, no new asphalt, no mask, no security shoes, nothing, carrying you know, the stones like on their head in buckets. So that was making a big scandal, and the transport system tried to excuse, yeah, it was not us, we ordered the enterprise, we didn't know that they